In today's lecture, we shall discuss about the predefined switch primitives in Verilog. And we shall also discuss about in detail the predesigned switch primitive NMOS and PMOS, and some examples how to model a Verilog code by using these predefined primitives. So here the ideal MOS switches which are predefined are NMOS, PMOS and CMOS. Resistive MOS switches are RNMOS, RPMOS, RCMOS. Here this R indicates resistive. Ideal bidirectional switches which are predefined in Verilog are TRAN, the transmission if 0. So now there is a control for the transmission. If it is 0, then only transmission will take place. Transmission if 1. Then resistive bidirectional switches are R TRAN if 0, R TRAN if 1. And power and ground nets which are predefined are supply 1 and supply 0. So supply 1 is used for VDD and supply 0 is used for ground. Then pull up and pull down, these are predefined. So we shall focus mostly on this first case, ideal MOS switches. Generally, designers, they don't use these type of switches for designing their entire circuit, because suppose if there are 1000 transistors in your circuit, so it is very difficult to design your whole 1000 transistors by using these type of switches, right? But this facility is provided in the Verilog, so you must understand what are these things. Now first we talk about NMOS switch. So this is one NMOS given here. This is the gate, which is called here control, then one input and one output. So if suppose this is NMOS, then here if you connect this terminal to ground, so this is your source terminal. And here this is drain terminal. Right? So you can connect your VDD here. And this is gate, and you can take the output here. So to turn on this MOSFET, so this gate is, you can say this is a control, right? This is a control input. If your gate terminal is at 0 volt, right, 0 volt means binary 0, then this NMOS is off, right? This NMOS is off. So if NMOS is off, then this NMOS will look like this. It is VDD here. Off MOSFET, off NMOS will act as an open circuit. So this is our source terminal, this is our drain terminal. And if you take the output across this MOSFET out, so what you will get? You will get VDD, right? So NMOS is off and output will be 1, that is VDD or VDD. And so this will be the condition when gate is connected with binary 0, 0 volt. And if gate is connected with plus 5 volt or VDD or with binary 1, then your NMOS is on, right? So to turn on your NMOS, at the gate terminal you have to supply binary 1, right? Now if this NMOS is on, then it will look like this. Here we have VDD. Now on MOSFET will act as a short circuit. It acts as a short circuit, right? This is source, this is drain, and here this is NMOS. And if you take output here now, Vout, so Vout you will get 0 volt. If you take any output across short circuit, you will get 0. So if NMOS is on, then output you will get 0. So now you see this truth table. Here you just concentrate here. If NMOS is control input is 1, right? If control input is 1, then whatever is at the input 0, you will get here at the output. And if it is 1, then you will get 1 here, right? So to declare this NMOS switch, the keyword is NMOS, and format for the instantiation is NMOS. Then you mention the instance name, but this is optional, but it is recommended that you should use the instance name. Then within the bracket you have to mention, you have to mention output, then input, then control, right? So output is drain, right? Whatever is the drain terminal, where the drain terminal is connected of this NMOS, so that you have to mention here in the output. Then for the input you have to mention the source terminal connection, and for the control you have to mention the gate connection. Okay, this is about the NMOS. And this is the PMOS, right? So you can identify NMOS and PMOS by this bubble here, right? You find this one small bubble. This indicates this is PMOS. Here you find there is no bubble here, right? So this indicates this is NMOS. Okay. So here, suppose this is your PMOS, this is VDD. So here source terminal is to be connected to VDD, right? Source terminal is to be connected to VDD. This is drain, this is gate. So in this particular case, if gate is 0, right? In case of PMOS, if gate is 0, then PMOS will turn on, right? If gate is 0, then PMOS will turn on, and if PMOS will turn on, then output you will get 0, right? Because if it will turn on, then it will look like this, a short circuit here, right? And this is VDD, and across this, if you measure the output voltage, then it will be 0. So to turn on PMOS, you have to apply 0 at the gate terminal, whereas in case of NMOS, you have to apply binary 1 at the gate terminal. And if gate terminal is at 1, that is at VDD, then PMOS is off, it will turn off. And if it will turn off, then the output will be VDD or binary 1. So just reverse of NMOS, it will perform the operation, right? Now to declare this PMOS switch, we have to use the keyword PMOS, and format for the instantiation is similar to the format of instantiation of NMOS. So you have to write the keyword PMOS, then name of the instance, then the sequence will be output, input, control. So here output will be your drain terminal, right? Just like PMOS, so output, whatever is the drain terminal, you have to mention that. For the input, you have to mention the source terminal, and for the control, you have to mention the gate terminal, right? So in this way you have to do the instantiation, right? So here also you can see the truth table. This you just see here, if the gate is 0, this control gate input is 0. So what we discussed, if gate input is 0, then the output will be 0, right? So here you are getting this output 0, right? And if input is 0, then output will be 0, and if input is 1, then output will be 1 in this case, right? So now here we will see one example of CMOS inverter, right? So this is the diagram of CMOS inverter. It performs the operation of NOT gate. Like this. So I will not go in detail how exactly, what is the working of this, but in actual this circuit diagram is a CMOS inverter. The meaning of CMOS here is, in CMOS inverter, how total number of NMOS and PMOS, not only in CMOS inverter, any CMOS logic, total number of NMOS and total number of PMOS will be same. How many number of NMOS you will use, same number of PMOS you have to use. And the advantage of CMOS inverter is, CMOS logic is, it consume less power. So here this is the inverter, and here X is the input and F is the output. So whatever input you will apply here, it will be inverted at the output section F. So I have to, suppose we have to model, we have to write the Verilog code for this inverter, right? So then how we have to write? So here you just see, suppose this is P1, PMOS, this is N1. The name of this NMOS is N1. So first I will write the various terminals of this. So this terminal is source, this terminal is drain, and this is gate. And if you talk about PMOS, then for PMOS, source is connected to VDD. So this is source and here this is drain. So drain terminal of PMOS and NMOS are joined together, and from there we have taken one wire and we are taking the output from there. Now we have to write the Verilog module for this. So here it is the Verilog module. The name of the module is module. Now we start with the keyword module and we end with end module. Name of this Verilog module is not underscore my. The various ports of this module is A, F, right? So A and, okay, A, I have taken A, right? So this is the input I have taken A, this is A, input is A and output is F. So input port is A and output port is F, this we have declared. Now supply 1, so this is one predefined primitive in case of Verilog, and this supply 1 is it is connected with VDD. So we have connected the supply 1 with the VDD, and supply 0 we have connected with ground. Now here this is first statement. This is first statement, first instantiation statement for the instantiation of PMOS. So we have to do the instantiation like this. First you write the PMOS keyword. Then see, this is a format of instantiation. NMOS or PMOS, if we are instantiating NMOS, then you have to use NMOS keyword, otherwise PMOS. Then instance name. So I have given the instance name here P1. For this instance name I have given P1. Then within bracket output input control, in this sequence we have to write. The sequence is important, you should not change the sequence. So for the output we have to mention the drain terminal, for the input source and gate. So the instance P1, this PMOS, what are its drain, source and gate terminal? We will write drain terminal of this PMOS is connected with F. So I have written here F. Then source terminal of this PMOS is connected with VDD. So I have written here VDD. Then gate terminal of this PMOS is connected with A input. So we have written here A. So this is the instantiation first statement. Then the instantiation second statement is the instantiation of NMOS. Write the keyword NMOS, then instance name N1. Now here also follow the same sequence, drain, source, gate. So drain of this NMOS is connected to output F. So we have written here F. Then source of this NMOS is connected with ground. So we have written ground, G and D. Then control, that gate of this NMOS is connected to A input. So we have written A. So in this way, we have to write the Verilog module of CMOS inverter. So I will just demonstrate this particular CMOS inverter code in the software. Okay, so this is the code. Right. Same code I have written here. Now I will check the behavioral syntax for this, so that if there is any syntax error, so I can find that here itself. There is no syntax error. Now I will simulate it. Okay. So at the A input, I will apply a clock here. I am applying a clock of 10 microsecond period, and I will run this simulation for 100 microseconds. Okay. Now you see. So first waveform is A, it is for A, then second is for F output, then VDD and ground. VDD and ground is constant. VDD will remain 1 for throughout the simulation and ground will remain 0 throughout the simulation. Now A, so we'll check at this particular time the value of A is 0. So the value of F is 1. It is inverted now. Now at this time you will see value of A is 1 and value of F is 0. It is inverted now. So anywhere you can check. Now here value of A is 0, F is 1. So this means our this code is working for a inverter. Right. Okay, now we will see how to write the Verilog code for 2-input NAND gate. 2-input NAND gate. So I am not going in detail how this particular diagram has to be made, right? This you have to study, of course, in VLSI, but it is not in Verilog subject domain, right? So you must learn this thing, how to draw the diagram at the MOSFET level, right? So here this is the diagram of 2-input NAND gate. Here the inputs are A and B and output is F. So this circuit performs the operation of 2-input NAND gate. So this means if we have the inputs A, B, suppose these are the inputs A and B and output is F, right? So if inputs are 0, 0, output will be 1. If it is 0, 1, output will be 1. If it is 1, 0, output will be 1. And if it is 1, 1, output will be 0. This particular truth table logic is performed by this circuit. So here for the 2-input NAND gate, we need 2 NMOS and 2 PMOS. NMOS are to be connected in series. So here you can find NMOS N1 and NMOS N2. They are connected in series. And PMOS are to be connected in parallel. So P1 and P2, these PMOS are connected in parallel. Okay. Now first I will write the various terminals, source, gate, drain of this particular means various and various MOSFETs of this particular circuit. So okay, we'll come to N2. So here this source means this terminal which is connected to ground is your source terminal, right? I write it to source of second NMOS. Now here we have drain of this N2 MOSFET. Now you come to N1. In N1, this terminal is source. This is source terminal, right? So source terminal of N1 and drain terminal of N2 are connected. And here we have drain terminal. I write it as drain 1. Now if you come to the PMOS, first we take P1. In P1, the terminal which is connected to VDD is source. So here this is source of first PMOS. And here this is the source of second PMOS. Right? So both the sources are connected to VDD. Now the other terminal is drain. So this is the drain terminal of first PMOS and this is the drain terminal of second PMOS. So the drain terminals of both the PMOS are joined together here at this point, and the drain terminal of NMOS is also joined with this, and from here we have taken one wire and we are taking the output from here. Okay, and gate of P1, this gate terminal of P1, it is connected to input A, and gate terminal of N1, this is gate, it is also connected to input A. Then in case of P2, the gate terminal of P2 is connected to input B, and the gate terminal of this N2 is connected with input B. So in this way this connection has to be completed. Okay. Now in this circuit diagram, if we find any intermediate connection which is not directly connected with input port or output port, is to be declared as wire in Verilog 4. So here you can see all the terminals are either connected to input or output port, but there is one particular wire, you see here this wire, right, this wire which is connecting with source of N1 with drain of N2. This wire is not connected either with input port or output port. Otherwise all the wires are either connected to input port or output port or VDD or ground, right? But only this wire is not connected either with input ports or with output ports or with VDD or with ground. So we have to declare this wire as this intermediate connection as wire. So X name I will give in my Verilog port to this wire. So now this is a Verilog port. So code will start with module and it ends with end module. The name of the Verilog module is NAND underscore my. The various ports are A, B and F. Input ports are A, B and output port is F. And I have declared one wire named as X, and this is this intermediate wire. Now supply 1 is VDD, supply 0 is ground. Now first instantiation statement, that is PMOS, and this is for instance P1. This is for P1 instance. So how we have to do the instantiation? You follow this drain source gate. In this sequence we have to write. So what is the drain for P1? Drain is connected with output F, right? Drain is connected with output F. So here we have written F. Then source, this is source, is connected with VDD, and gate is connected with A input. Now come to the next PMOS instantiation, that is of P2. This is my P2. So again follow the same sequence, drain, source, gate. So drain of this P2, this is connected with output F. So here we have written F. Then source is connected with VDD. So you can see this source, this wire is connected with VDD. Then gate is connected with input B. This gate is connected with input B. Okay. Then we will come to the instantiation of NMOS. So for that we have written keyword NMOS. Then instance N1. N1 is this instance. So drain, source, gate, in this sequence we have to write. So what is the drain? Drain is connected with F, output. So here we have written F. Then where is the source? This is the source. Source is connected with the wire X. So we have written X. And gate of this NMOS here, it is connected with input A. So here we have written A. Then we will come to the instantiation of next NMOS. So NMOS N2. N2 is the name of the instance. Then drain of this N2. This drain is connected with wire X. So we have written this X. Then source. This source is connected with ground. So GND. And gate is connected with input B. So it is B. So this is the whole Verilog module of two input NAND gates. So again I will simulate this two input NAND gate module and show you the result of this. So this code I will just paste here. Okay. And now I will first check the syntax of this code. There is no syntax error. Now I will simulate this code. Okay, now I will apply two clock signals on input A and B. First I am applying a clock signal on input A. The time period of this clock I am giving 10 microseconds. Now I will apply another clock on B input and time period I will just change it. I will make it 13 microseconds. Okay. Now I will run this simulation for 100 microseconds. Okay. This is the output here. Right, so here you can see the first waveform is for A, then B, then F. So we will concentrate on these. X value is also mentioned here. So first we will concentrate on A, B and F only. So here at this particular moment the value of A is 0, B is 0. So for NAND gate if this is the condition then output will be 1. So here you find 1. We check another condition when input is A is 1, B is 0. So for this also output is 1. We check another condition if both the inputs are 1, then also output is 0. You can find here it is 0. If input A is 0, B is 1, then output is 1. Right? Okay. So in this way this code is perfectly working for working as a two input NAND gate logic. Okay. Okay, now I will discuss about two input NOR gates, right? A very long code for that. So for the two input NOR gate, if you see the diagram of two input NAND gate, here you find NMOS are connected in series and PMOS are connected in parallel. But in two input NOR gate, NMOS will be connected in parallel and PMOS will be connected in series. So the circuit diagram will be like this. Here we have one PMOS. Suppose this is P1. Here this end is VDD. Connected to VDD. So this is source. Here it is drain. Now second PMOS will be connected in series with first PMOS. This is P2. So for P2 this terminal is source and this terminal is drain. Now we will come to NMOS. NMOS are connected in parallel. This is first NMOS N1. Here this is the drain terminal and here this is the source terminal. This is second NMOS. In the name of this NMOS I have given N2. So here it is drain terminal and this is source terminal. Both the source terminal of NMOS will be joined together and it is connected to ground. And drain terminal of NMOS are joined together here and it is connected with the drain terminal of PMOS and from here the output will be taken. So the output is F. Right. Now here P1 and NMOS, gates of P1 and N1 are joined together and from here we will take the input E. And the gates of P2 and N2 are joined together. Okay, and from here we will take input P. So this is the circuit diagram of 2-input NOR gate and now we will see the Verilog module. So it starts with module keyword and it ends with end module. The name of this Verilog module is NOR_MY. The ports are A, B, F. Input ports are A, B. Output port is F and wire. Yes. Now we see whether there is any intermediate wire which is neither connected with VDD or ground or input ports or output ports. So yes, there is one wire. You see here, this wire. It is intermediate wire. It is not connected with VDD, nor with ground, nor with input ports, nor with output port. So this I have declared as X. So this is wire X. Now supply 1 is VDD, supply 0 is ground. Now I will do the instantiation of PMOS P1. Right? So for that PMOS is the keyword, then P1 is the instance name. So what is the sequence? Sequence is same, right? Drain, source, gate. So drain of this P1 is connected with X. So X, source is, this source is connected with VDD and gate is connected with input A. Now we will do the instantiation of P2. So PMOS, P2, drain, source, gate. In this sequence we have to write. So drain of P2 is connected with output F. This, the source is connected with wire X. This and gate is connected with input B. Now we will do the instantiation of NMOS N1. So this is N1. Sequence drain source gate. So drain of NMOS N1. This is drain is connected with output F. So F. Source is connected with ground. Source is connected with ground. And gate, this is gate, is connected with input A. Now we will do the instantiation of NMOS N2. So for this also drain is connected with output F, source is connected with ground and gate is connected with input B. So this is the value of module of CMOS 2 input NOR gate. So I will demonstrate this. So CMOS 2 input NOR gate means if both the inputs are 0, then we will get output 1. Otherwise, we will get output 0. Okay. So now I will check the syntax. Now I will simulate this. Now I will apply the clock signal on A and B. I will apply the clock of 10 microsecond time period on A, and on B input I will apply a clock of time period 13 microseconds. Now I will run this simulation for 100 microseconds. This is the waveform. Okay. So here first value is for A input, second value is for B input, and third value is for F output. So we see here, first in this case inputs are 0 and 0. So output will be 1. So we are getting output 1. Now if input A is 1, B is 0. So if any one input is 1, then output will be 0. So we see output is 0. Now you see both the inputs are 1, A and B both are 1, so output is 0. Now we see this condition, if input A is 0, B is 1, so now also output is 0. If both the inputs are 0, in this case now we see A is 0, B is 0, output is 1. So in this way this code is working perfectly fine for 2 input NAND gate. Okay.